Now we'll study about the profitability ratios. Again, I'll revise. We have four types of accounting ratios: liquidity ratio, leverage ratio, turnover ratio, and profitability ratio. We have studied all these three. Now we'll be going for profitability ratio, which is very important. So in the turnover ratios, we have studied these types. I'll directly go for profitability ratios. We all know that profit is a very, very important part of any type of business. We do business because we want profits. So profit is a measure of efficiency and control of business activities. If you have profit, then only it says that your business, you're running your business in a more efficient way. Your business is efficient. Its activities are efficient, else no. So measurement of profit is a function of accounts. Okay. When we measure the profit, it is a function of accounts. Accounts maadbekadre ni what is the profit anta measure maadthiri. Okay. Whereas what is profitability? It's a function of financial analysis. Profitability anadhen antirala, it's a function of financial analysis. Then analyze maadadaga in what way is your profitability anta helthiri. So that is financial analysis. Profitability ratio reflect the capacity to earn profits. Such capacity to earn profits depends upon two factors: sales and investment. Remember this. When we are analyzing the profitability, it tells how you can earn still more profits, or what are the things that are connected with the profits. So they are specially two factors. One is sales and one is investment. Sales, that is a relationship between profit and sales. Okay, we call them as profit margin ratios also. Investment is a relationship between profit and investment. Okay, this we call them as rate of return ratios. These are profit margin ratios and these are rate of return ratios. So in the sales, say a relationship between profit and sales is shown by computing profit margin ratios. What are those types? We have gross profit ratio, okay, operating ratio, expenses ratio, operating profit ratio, and net profit ratio. Okay, I'll tell you, we have five types: gross profit ratio, operating ratio, expenses ratio, operating profit ratio, and net profit ratio. We'll be studying all these one by one. These are the different types of investment ratios. We call them as rate of return ratios always. You see, return on investment, ROI, very important. Return on total resources, return on equity, this is also important, ROE. Earning per share ratio, EPS, this is very, very, very important. EPS, you'll get it for 2 marks. Fixed assets turnover ratio and debt to total fund ratio. Okay, so we'll see here. First, we'll go for profit, gross profit ratio. First, we'll study all these profitability ratio. First, idina nodana. Afterwards, we'll go for this rate of return ratios, investment ratios. So first, we'll go for gross profit ratio. It is calculated by dividing gross profit by net sales. Gross profit and net sales. Profit, we are comparing profits with the sales. So it is always divided by net sales. So gross profit ratio is equal to gross profit divided by net sales into 100. Gross profit, all of you should know that. In the earlier method, you would calculate a gross profit. How would you calculate? In the trading account, hope all of you remember. Sales minus cost of goods sold is known as gross profit. There are so many methods of finding out the gross profit. You see here, the difference between net sales and cost of goods sold is known as gross profit. It means what? Gross profit is equal to net sales minus goods sold. This is one of the formula. Or there are many other methods also. Now, first is net sales. This formula we'll analyze. What is net sales? Net sales is total sales minus sales returns. What is total sales? Cash sales spread plus credit sales. This I have been telling since many times. Total sales is cash sales plus credit sales minus sales returns, that is sales, net sales. What is cost of goods sold? This we have done it previously also. Opening stock plus purchases plus all direct expenses. Okay, minus closing stock. Opening stock tagotiri, adakke purchases add martiri, all direct expenses add martiri. Deduct closing stock. What is that? That is the cost of goods sold. So what is gross profit? Net sales minus cost of goods sold, you will get cost gross profit. So what is the interpretation? Usually for profits, we never say this much percent is profit. What we do is it is compared with last year or the profits of the companies which are into similar business. Compare gross profit of last year and those of other concern carrying similar business. If gross profit is high, it indicates good results. If it is low, it indicates poor results. Okay. Where take down this problem. Yeah. From the following information, calculate gross profit ratio. Cash sales 25% of total sales. Purchases is 11,80,000. Closing stock 3,60,000. Credit sales 8,22,000 and opening stock is 1,80,000. Okay, we have to find out gross profit ratio. So what is gross profit ratio? Here we have the formula. It is gross profit divided by net sales into 100. So first I am finding the total sales. Why? Because in the sales part I know only this. What is that? Cash sales is 25% of total sales and I know the credit sales. Okay, this is the data given. From this you have to find out total sales. So firstly we'll find out total sales, calculation of total sales. It is given 25% of total sales. That means if total sales is 100, cash sales is 25. Okay, so what happens? The deduction, whatever you get remaining, 75 is our credit sales. Understood this? If credit sales is 75, total sales is 100. Okay. Now, if credit sales is 8,22,000, then what is the total sales? So what I did here, 8,22,000 divided by 75 into this 100. You will get 10,96,000. What is this? This is our total sales. Okay, take down this. So now, calculation of total sales. So here, cost of goods sold. Sorry, this is calculation of cost of goods sold actually. CGS, cost of goods sold. Calculation of cost of goods sold. Opening stock 1,80,000. Okay, so we have here opening stock 1,80,000. This is the problem part. I'm taking 1,80,000 here. Add purchases. Purchases is 11,80,000. So I'm taking it here. So this is the total I will get here. 13,60,000. I'm adding here. We don't have any direct expenses. So I have added and we have got 13,60,000. In this you have to deduct the closing stock 3,60,000. Closing stock 3,60,000 is deducted. Idu less martiri. So 13,60,000 minus 3,60,000, you will get 10 lakhs as cost of goods sold. Okay, now we will find out what is gross profit. Gross profit is net sales divided by cost of goods sold. So gross profit is equal to net sales is 10,96,000. This we got from our previous calculation, total sales. So net sales is 10,60,000. Cost of goods sold, I've got here 10 lakhs, that is taken here 10 lakhs. So 10,96,000 minus 10 lakhs, you will get 96,000. This is the gross profit. Okay. Next, we will find out the gross profit ratio. So gross profit ratio is equal to gross profit divided by net sales into 100. This we have already seen. So gross profit, we get 96,000 and net sales is 10,96,000. Into 100, you will get 8.759. I have written it as 8.76. Okay. This is the gross profit ratio. So next we'll go for operating ratio. It is calculated by dividing cost of goods sold plus operating expenses by net sales. You see the formula here. Operating ratio is equal to cost of goods sold plus operating expenses divided by net sales. This ratio establishes the relationship between total operating expenses and sales. Total operating expenses include what? Operating expenses, that is cost of goods sold, administrative expenses, financial expenses, and selling expenses. So you can take cost of goods sold separately plus all the operating expenses, administrative, financial, and selling expenses. So here you can see this. Net sales, we have been seeing this. Net sales is equal to total sales minus sales return, this net sales. Total sales minus sales return. Cost of goods sold, again same, opening stock plus purchases plus all direct expenses minus closing stock. Operating expenses, administrative expenses, financial expenses, and selling expenses. Okay, we'll see here. Take down this problem. From the following income statement, calculate operating ratio for all the 3 years. 3 years data is given here, 2015, 2016, and 2017. We have to find out what the operating ratio. What all is given? Net sales is given directly. Okay. This is the net sales that is given 60,000, 1 lakh, 1,20,000. Less cost of sales, that is goods sold, 40,000. 70,000 and 80,000. So when you deduct this, you will get 20,000. 1 lakh minus 70,000, you'll get 30,000. And 120 minus 80, you will get this as 40,000. Less expenses. What expenses you have? Selling expenses and general and administrative expenses. Selling expenses, 6,000, 7,000, and 9,000. General and administrative expenses, you'll get 4,000, 4,000, and 4,000. So what are the operating expenses? These are the operating expenses. That is, you're adding here 6,000 plus 4,000, 10,000. 7,000 plus 4,000, you'll get 11,000. 9,000 plus 4,000, you'll get 13,000. Okay. Now, what is your operating income? That is gross profit. Okay. Minus operating expenses. 20,000 minus 10,000, 10,000. 30 minus 11 is 19,000. 40 minus 13 is 26,000. This is the problem part. It can you just tell it's called Bekagila. This is the problem given. Now we have to find out the operating ratio. So here we all know that operating ratio is equal to cost of goods sold plus operating expenses divided by net sales into 100. So we know the net sales, it is already given. This is the given data. You see, this I have taken from problem. ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಒಳಗಿಂದ ನಮಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬೇಕು ನಾನು ಅದಷ್ಟೇ ತಕ್ಕೊಂಡಿನಿ. ಸೊ ನೆಟ್ ಸೇಲ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಗಿವನ್ 60,000, 1 lakh ಅಂಡ್ 1,20,000. ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೇಲ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಗೂಡ್ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್, 40, 70 and 80. ಆಪರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಆಪರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಅದಲ್ಲ, ಸೇಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಹಿಯರ್, 10,000, 11,000 and 30,000. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅವರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ. ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟಿಟ್ಯೂಟ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಪರ್ ಇಯರ್. ಯು ಸಿ 2015, ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಯರ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ 2015. ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಗೂಡ್ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್, ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್? 40,000. ಸೊ 40 ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೇಕನ್. ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಆಪರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಸ್ 10, ಐ ಟೇಕ್ ಹಿಯರ್ 10. Divided by 60,000, what is this net sales? 60,000 is taken over here. So 40 plus 10 is 50, divided by 60 into 100. 50,000 divided by 60 into 100, you will get 83.33%. okay, similarly you do for 2016 and 2017. Cost of goods sold 70,000 plus operating expenses is 11,000, divided by what? 1 lakh. So this is 81,000 divided by 1 lakh into 100, you will get 81%. Here it is 80,000 plus 13,000, you will get this as 93,000, divided by net sales 1,20,000, 1,20,000, you will get 77.5%. This is the operating ratio. So we'll go for the next one, expense ratios. These ratios are calculated by dividing each expenses, see here, each expenses by net sales. Each expenses will be taking here divided by net sales. These expenses are also known as supporting ratios or operating inefficiency of the business. The following are the few expense ratios. You may have any type of expenses ratios. What are the common ones that will be taking here? Factory expense ratio. You see, factory expenses ratio, factory expenses divided by net sales. Factory expenses will be given directly, that divided by net sales into 100. Administration expenses ratio, this is administrative expenses divided by net sales into 100. Then you have selling expenses ratio, selling expenses ratio, selling expenses divided by net sales into 100. Then last one is non-operating expenses. Non-operating expenses ratio is equal to non-operating expenses divided by net sales into 100. Take down all this. So on this, you'll be doing problems later. I'll tell you they are very simple. We'll go for the next one, that is operating profit ratio. First, what you did is operating ratio. Now what you're doing is operating profit ratio. In operating ratio, you have done cost of goods sold. I'll show it here. This is our operating ratio, cost of goods sold divided by operating expenses divided by net sales into 100. This is operating ratio. Now we'll go for operating profit ratio. It is calculated by dividing operating profit by net sales. There we took expenses. Here we are taking profit, operating profit divided by net sales. Operating profit divided by net sales into 100. So net sales is total sales minus sales return. This today we are repeating it continuously. And operating profit is also known as EBIT, earnings before interest and tax. EBIT divided by net sales, that is nothing but operating profit ratio. All of you know operating profit ratio. In the financial management, you have done many problems on this EBIT, EPS calculation. So this is the same. Operating profit is equal to net profit plus non-operating expenses minus operating expenses. Okay, we found out the EBIT, or operating profit is equal to gross profit minus operating expenses, or it is sales minus variable cost minus fixed cost. Okay, it depends on what type of data is given. Based on that data, you have to find out the operating profit if it is not given. If it is given directly, no issues. But if data is given, bare bare thara data nimu kottirtare, avag en madbeku, you have to find out. So interpretation standard ratio is 10%. Standard ratio for operating profit ratio is 10%. If operating profit is 10% or more, it indicates efficiency. Else, it is inefficiency. Last, we'll go for this net profit ratio. Later on, I'll give problems on both of these. Net profit ratio, it is calculated by dividing net profit by net sales. Gross profit madidviyala, similarly here, net profit. Only thing is, this is net profit after tax. With the help of this ratio, the efficiency of the management in manufacturing, selling and administration and other activities of the firms can be assessed. Always our final profit is net profit. Gross profit is for our main sales and purchases. Later on, when we reduce all the expenses, we come for this net profit, especially income and expenses statement, administrative and selling expenses, you reduce, you will get net profit. So this ratio is the overall measure of the firm's profitability. We always depend on net profit, not the gross profit. So net profit ratio formula is this. This is always after tax. Tax illa kaladmal en ulithadala, that net profit we are considering, not before tax. So net profit after tax divided by net sales into 100. Okay. So higher the ratio, profitability is good. Less ratio, profitability is poor. So take down this problem. From the following information, calculate net profit ratio. Sales 15 lakhs, cost of goods sold 9 lakhs, office and administrative expenses 3 lakhs, provision for tax 1,20,000. Everything is given over here. You have to find out net profit ratio. So firstly, we will find out calculation of net profit. Sales 15 lakhs is given. So sales, I am taking 15 lakhs. Less cost of goods sold 9 lakhs is given. So cost of goods sold 9 lakhs. When you reduce this, what you will get? You will get gross profit. What is that? That is 6 lakhs you have got. Within this, what you will do now, you reduce office and administrative expenses. Office and administrative expenses, where it is here, 3 lakhs. So, this 3 lakhs I have taken. When you reduce this 3 lakhs from the 6 lakhs, you will get 3 lakhs. What is this 3 lakhs net profit before tax? Tax reduce madukina madlu, what you get, that is before tax. Tax is already given. Provision for tax is 1,20,000. So less tax, 1,20,000. Net profit after tax is 1,80,000. Okay. This is our net profit after tax. Now, what is our formula? Actually, it is only this part. Net profit after tax. Okay. You can find out only this, or you can find out both. That is net profit before tax. You have to take net profit before tax divided by sales. So before tax and profit estitu, it is 3 lakhs. Okay. So 3 lakhs divided by 15 lakhs, you will get 20%. Into 100, you will get 20%. As per our formula, that is net profit after tax. Net profit after tax divided by net sales into 100. Net profit after tax, in our previous, we found out it is 1,80,000. So 1,80,000 divided by 15 lakhs into 100, you will get 12%. This is our net profit ratio. Okay. Do this problem. So today you have studied about all these ratios. I'll go back and I'll show you. These are the profitability ratios based on sales. Okay. We call them as profit margin ratios. You have gross profit ratio, operating ratio, expenses ratio, operating profit ratio and net profit ratios. We have studied all these five types. Okay. We will do some more problems in our next part. Okay. So thank you. I'll go back here.